you're talking about. God can do whatever you want.
Yes, he can.
Yes, Lord. Jesus.
It's Saturday night, y'all.
Yes, Lord.
Give me a couple more minutes.
Take your time.
Take your time. You was here, Sean. This time last year, and I was preaching on a Saturday night like I'm doing now. And I came from Ezekiel 37 chapter.
Uh-huh.
These dry bones.
Yes, yes.
And there was some instruction that the Spirit gave Ezekiel.
Yes.
And while God gave Ezekiel those instructions, the Spirit gave me the same one.
My Lord.
And I said, get some dry bones.
Yeah.
When I first came here, this church was a valley of dry bones.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Valley of dry bones. And it was very dry.
Uh-huh.
I said, my Lord, I felt like Ezekiel. Heard the Spirit, can these dry bones live?
Uh-huh.
I looked at them jokers and said, Lord, I don't know it.
Yes, Lord.
And that night, I looked at it, I said, now prophesy to the world. I said, and tell the wind to breathe into them.
My Lord.
And when I said, tell the wind to breathe into them, I started feeling,
my Lord,
a brush of wind.
Jesus. Jesus.
And I looked and I said, I feel the wind.
Jesus. Jesus.
Sister Danielle was sitting there.
Yeah.
Gloria was sitting over there.
Yes, yes.
And I looked and I said, I feel the wind right here.
That's right.
Next thing you know, the Spirit of the Lord got the wind. We started letting the Lord have his way. Next thing you know, next thing you know, folks that was calling on Jesus are speaking in an unknown tongue.
Yes! Yes! Amen.
Holy Ghost started moving it. Holy Ghost moving it. And Holy Ghost moving it. I'm sitting over there and I'm trying
hey.
To get calm, and I'm just trying to look and just
uh-huh.
pray that the Lord would have his way. And wow, Sister Gloria being filled with yeah. the Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
And filled with the Holy Ghost. That makes Sister Danielle call out to the Lord even stronger.
Yes, yes.
Oh, wait a minute. You ain't gonna give it to her and not give it to me. She's out calling on the name of the Lord. Holy Ghost. Boom. And when the Holy Ghost filled her,
hey.
Here comes Sister Sweetie.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
The Lord just popped my little
head. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Her left ear was only operating at 25%.
My Lord.
She can hardly hear out of the ear.
Hallelujah.
And been doing it for years.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You be all close up to her. She ain't heard nothing you said. You look at the ask you.
Amen.
Move to the right side.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But my God was filling
my
in the news.
My Lord.
We on the brink of eternity. When that
my Lord.
Trump get up in there, y'all gonna really see.
Amen.
My Lord.
Closer to the coming of the Lord we are.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Y'all don't see the sign of the time?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey.
It is not something in you that makes you feel like you ought to draw closer.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know about you, but this thing feels like a magnet to
yes,
me.
Yes.
Sometimes I'm walking and I feel this magnetic pull.
My Lord.
I don't know about y'all, but those that got the Holy Ghost should know what I'm talking
my
about.
My Lord.
Yes. I'm driving, I feel a
magnetic pull. My Lord.
I'm just seeing like I'm going higher.
Jesus,
while
Jesus.
I'm sitting in the car, I feel the Holy Ghost moving.
Jesus.
I'm just going higher. And
Jesus.
Every time I turn around in the shower, I feel a magnetic pull pulling me
Jesus.
Higher. Don't y'all know any day now that pull won't get stronger?
My Lord.
And he'll snatch us up out of here.
My Lord.
Snatch us up. He got to get the dead in Christ.
Lord.
But you got to have something.
That's right.
To catch you on.
That's right.
Can I tell y'all something, church? We are in an hour. Singing is good. We love singing, but singing ain't getting us out of here.
No, sir.
Our dressing and our colors ain't getting us out of here.
No, sir.
The only thing that's getting us out of here is the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And you better have the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That's why I don't understand why churches are not.
Amen.
You're too busy preaching a whole bunch of other foolish stuff.
Amen.
Let me tell y'all something. I ain't got time to sit here and argue about whether a woman can preach or whether you should wear a wedding band or not and all that type of crazy stuff. I'm not preaching and talking about whether or not you should sit here and wear certain colors or not. I'm not doing none of that foolishness.
Uh-huh.
Because while we sitting there talking for hours about that dumb stuff, I could be praying somebody due to the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
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 Jesus.
Amen.
What I'm talking about you, I'm sitting here talking to you about this foolish stuff, woman.
Amen.
And this year, I ain't going to nobody's minister meeting.
Tell the truth. Tell the truth.
Hey, you can't come on the phone when you sit down and have a conversation. No, we cannot.
That's right. That's right.
Because that 1 and 2 hours I'm going to spend with you, I could be sitting there praying that somebody's soul might be saved.
Yeah.
Something's too occupied with everything else but God.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
No debate.
Occupied with everything but God.
Yes.
We sitting there trying to figure out how to raise more funds for the building. But if you trust God, God will make everything
come. Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
We broke as a joke, but God supplied everything.
Yes, he
is. Is that right?
Amen.
Since I've been here, the lights ain't been cut off. The gas ain't been shut off. Ain't nothing happened. God will supply.
Yes, he will.
Right.
Yes, he will.
Amen.
What I'm getting caught up for, I got to run and do this and run and do that
right.
When I can trust in the Lord.
Trust
Amen.
In the
Lord. Yes. All right.
That's why folks think I'm crazy.
No, you got good
sense.
No, you're not crazy.
That man crazy. Let them young people sit there carrying on the way they carrying on.
Jesus.
Oh, they got to be crazy.
No.
Let them get in there and shout and whoop and holler, make all that noise. He got to be crazy.
No, it's all right.
Let them over there play them instruments and making all that noise. You got to be crazy.
No.
You right, I'm crazy enough to keep them in the house of God.
Hey, that's right.
Out there in the street, you talking about
them.
Yeah, in the house of God, you still want to talk
that's
about
right.
You know how folks are, they kind of bipolar in the street.
Yes, yes.
They don't want to see me do wrong, and they don't want to see me do good. But the devil is a liar.
Yes,
you
yes.
Keep doing what you're doing for the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Because of you say so.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Yes.
No.
Free.
Yeah. Take
they
your time.
They ain't got no long sleeves on.
Oh, Lord.
Jesus.
And them skirts ain't long enough.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Free.
But they in the house.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
How are you in the house? Going out here prostituting somebody.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Laying up with somebody you ain't got no business laying up with.
Yeah.
All right, I make you come in here and sing. See, you want to sing till 1 o'clock? Stay right here and sing.
Uh-huh.
I know how to get in my car, leave y'all here with the keys, and go home.
what he do. Amen.
That's right. The spirit is not bound.
That's right. Amen.
Hey, man.
Oh, Lord. Well, that's right. Blair, you got them brothers over there walking around laying hands on people. I thought you was the pastor of the church. I am.
Amen.
Amen.
You know what a pastor is? A pastor is an overseer.
Amen.
You know what an elder is? An elder is an overseer.
That's right.
You know what a bishop is? A bishop is an overseer. Watching.
Right.
And discerning. And if it gets you out of hand, I'm going to tap you on the shoulder and say, brother, seek and see.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And I'm going to watch.
Amen.
And I'm going to look.
Amen.
And I'm going to correct. But one thing I'm not going to do, I'm not going to hinder the move of God.
Amen.
And telling y'all a bunch of my faults is not more important than the Spirit of God moving.
That's right.
Because you know what folk do anyway. By the time you get up there, the Holy Ghost done move, and you said all this stuff that you want to say now, still trying to preach a sermon after the Holy Ghost done move, you're in your flesh anyway.
Tell the truth.
You're in your flesh. So I want to move the Spirit out of the way in order that flesh can take place. That's why ain't nobody getting saved.
My Lord.
I'm going to move out the way so I can speak. But did y'all read the book of Chronicles? When the power of God and the glory came in the house, the Bible said the priest couldn't even stand up to minister. Sometimes the preacher needs to shut up.
Amen.
Sometimes the preacher needs to shut up. If God's moving, you shut up. What you got to say when God's talking? What you got to say when God's moving?
Amen.
What you got to say when God ministers? But amen and thank you, Jesus.
That's right. That's right.
You want to get up here, and all you want to do is get up here and hammer for an hour and a half about women preachers and mama's apparel and the same surface joke you've been preaching for years. Don't know no other scriptures in the Bible.
That's right.
Amen.
I want to know why they don't like me. That's why they don't like me.
Yes.
You got to impart into the people. Amen. You got to impart into people in order that you can see them walk in the abilities that God has given them.
Yes. Sure. Yes.
Amen.
That's right. Sure.
Amen. Build them up.
That's right.
Let me tell y'all something. And I'm going to pick y'all. This anniversary, I'm going down memory lane. Mm-hmm. Brother David came in here quiet as a mouse.
Amen.
That's right. Well, no, our brother was in the room. Looking, watching, and listening. But the day was coming. But the day came coming, kept coming. He was coming, you know, he would clap his hands, you know. He's real modest and everything. Oh, but one Tuesday night.
My Lord.
I said, you want the Holy Ghost? I said, you ought to jump out your seat right now.
Hey, man.
He ain't think about it.
Yeah.
He ain't question it.
Hallelujah.
That boy jump out that seat.
Yes,
and
he did.
He jumped out that seat. God jumped into his soul. And that boy went speaking.
Yes, God. Yes, God. Amen.
And I done seen that boy few months.
Yes. Yes. Amen. Amen.
You can't tell
powerful.
Me
you got the Holy Ghost. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You can't make me powerful.
That's right.
And I know he got it the Bible when that boy came in here to prayer Friday night.
Yeah.
After that Tuesday. As soon as he hit his knees before any word could come out, it was an unknown tongue. That
yes.
Talk no English.
Yes.
He didn't know what English was.
My Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I just said God work with him.
Yes.
I'm just saying God developing him.
Amen.
Amen.
That boy got in here singing on, was that last night?
Yeah. Yes.
Boy got singing, started singing last night. And, you know,
yes.
And just, you know, at first I just be singing, you know.
Yeah.
Singing. You said, oh. But the anointing came on that boy.
Uh-huh.
You would have thought he was doing this thing professionally.
Right.
He started going for it, and I think he shocked himself. That boy got the word, what can wash away my sin? Caught out, boy. I didn't know what to say. All you do is lift his hand.
Thank you, Lord.
Wonderful.
This is what we're here for.
Amen.
To build them up.
Yes.
Yeah, that's right.
And we don't do it, the world gonna do it.
Yes.
Right.
Amen.
And let me say this, y'all.
Jesus, thank you.
I promise I'm trying.
No. Take your time.
Take your time.
Take your time.
We condemn too much.
Amen.
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 We condemn too much. All we do is condemn.
Every.
Yeah.
Every.
Condemn. Condemn. But what if God did that to you?
Yeah, you wouldn't make it.
What if God only condemn? Don't y'all know God shows us mercy?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Even when we don't deserve it.
Amen.
Yes.
God is full of mercy. So the church should be full of mercy.
Amen.
There's people in this ministry that have confidence in me to come tell me stuff that they're involved in, that they're doing, that they struggle with. Because they know it's going to be a non-judgment zone.
Uh-huh.
I'm not your judge.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
I'm your leader.
Amen.
And it's my job to lead you away from the error.
Right.
Not condemn you for it.
Amen.
So if you come to me and say, I got this issue, it's my job to teach you how to overcome it.
Yes.
In the church, we want to put people out of the church.
Uh-huh.
Sit them down. You doing this and you doing that. And therefore, you're hell bound. The devil is a liar.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to talk to you and I'm going to let you get up and sing tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
So if you were in my church, you'd be set down. That's why ain't nobody in your church.
Amen.
You'd be set down. But what about grace and mercy?
Yes.
What about instructing them and then allowing the grace of God and the mercy of God to step in and say, I warned you this time, but you better get it together.
Right.
And let me tell y'all something. I know I sound crazy, but I done seen them be delivered in the midst of their sin.
Right.
The only thing sitting them down gonna do is make them wallow in the condemnation that they're in. Make them feel even more guilty. Make them feel less than. And you know what the enemy gonna do? He gonna snatch them and take them right out of them doors. I'm showing them that God loves you enough to pick you up and dust you off and say, go your way and sin no more.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
I got no condemnation. I'm leading you away from there.
Yeah, right.
And the next thing you know, they'll start overcoming.
Uh-huh.
Start overcoming. We got to treat these people like God treats us.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
And I wish I had a broadcast that could go into the entire world. Especially in the home of so-called apostolic holiness people.
Yes, yes.
When God sent Jesus Christ, he did not send him to the world. He sent him to his own people. To correct the errors of their ways. And let me let y'all know something. Long now bled him sent me to the apostolic church to get y'all straight.
Amen.
Amen. Because we've been carrying on foolishness for too long.
Amen.
Foolishness for too long. And God is not pleased with it.
Amen.
If Jesus can look at a woman who the folks found in the very act of adultery. Wasn't nobody assuming what she did? They saw her doing what she did. But that caused me to think a little bit though.
That's fine.
What was you doing that you saw it?
Amen.
That's
right. Amen.
That's how I check. Folks ain't doing that type of stuff just out in plain open, you know, just sometimes they going behind closed doors trying to hide away. What was you doing looking?
Amen.
The problem in the church, some folk look too much.
Yes, yes.
Some of us are watching too much.
Yes, yes.
Some of us stay encouraged and we try to look to see your faults in order that we may bring them out.
Yes, yes.
Amen. You
show them too. Amen. You look at the way she's walking. Look what she got on.
Yeah.
Trying to find something.
Yeah.
Yes, amen.
That's
true.
Yes,
trying to find something.
What
was you doing looking?
Amen.
How you know what she was doing?
Amen.
Jesus, she did it. Yeah, she did it. And then they were partial in that.
Right.
Because the law said, bring both of them.
That's right.
That's right.
Law said, bring both of them.
Yeah.
They only bought her.
That's right.
Y'all ever wonder why preachers preach on the women in the church so much?
Tell it to them.
And then you let the brothers in the church get away with anything.
Yeah.
And I looked at all the apostolic folk with a double standard.
Amen.
Got our true women dressed around, walking around, looking like mummies, all and they going outside with tank tops on.
All right. Yes.
Brothers going outside with tank tops on, showing all their arm, and we got the sister with them sleeves all the way down here.
Okay. Amen.
And got the nerve to start talking. I was saying, bring both of them.
That's right.
They only brought her. Bought her. They ain't complaining about what she did. Jesus kneels down and he writes on the ground. These crazy people. You know it was elders, right? You know. They always let the city bought out. He stooped down, wrote and said, "Boy, look, let he that is without sin
cast the first."
Cast the first stone. He started thinking, what I did last night.
Yeah. Yeah. Where was I?
What I did this morning.
Yeah.
What don't y'all know the church had that same attitude?
That's right.
Quick to condemn somebody that's pregnant when you was fornicating last night.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
The grace of God.
Yeah.
Your folly ain't been manifested.
Yeah.
Yet.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 Amen. You're talking about somebody sitting there fornicating, you sleeping with somebody else's husband. Right in the church.
Amen.
That's right.
And then you fussing about somebody getting pregnant. Put them out in the church. Put them out in the church. They can't sing on the choir. But what if the Lord would unveil what you
do? Yes, yes, yes. That's right.
Lord have mercy.
Ain't y'all glad God got a whole bunch of mercy?
Amen.
What if God got into the exposing business?
Yes.
And not only expose the stuff that you did, but what about the thoughts that you had?
Yes.
You know that stuff that can't nobody see.
Yes.
Help
Amen.
All right. The church better start showing some more mercy. Because let me tell y'all something. God gonna get to the place where he gonna start exposing us.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
He'll start exposing to bring you to open shame. And the ones that you didn't forgive, he been unforgave, and you still wallowing in your shame.
Yeah, that's the truth.
Jesus wrote and said, "Let he that is without sin cast the first stone." Jesus knew that he was the only one standing there
that was
sinless.
That's right.
Amen.
That was out sin.
They all, one by one, started putting stones down.
Uh-huh.
Jesus was the only one justified in picking up a stone and knocking her upside her head.
Yeah.
But instead of Jesus doing that,
mercy.
Mercy.
He looked up at her and said, "Where have thy accusers gone? They haven't accused you, neither do I. Go your way and sin no more."
Amen. No more.
Thank you, Lord. My
Savior, Lord.
To be like Jesus. To be like Jesus. How I love to be like him. Stand on me. So meek and lowly. So humble and holy. We thank the Lord God for this service. We thank the Lord God for been said and done. We thank the Lord God even for this offering. We thank the Lord God for those that had to give and those that had not to give. We pray, Lord God, that you bless them at the next appointed time to be able to give. We ask you, Lord God, that this will help for the furtherance of the gospel.
Amen.
And Lord, we thank you for all those that took the time out to come and help us celebrate this 41st church anniversary and first pastoral anniversary. We ask you, Lord God, that you bless them in a mighty special way. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, my strength, my redeemer. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And we say amen. Brothers and sisters.
Before everybody leaves, we have two presentations.
I'm sorry.
We have two presentations, Mr. Ben did not know about.
Oh.
So first we're going to call up the South Church.